Hello everyone and welcome to my workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at upgrading the Pi 5 network speeds to 2.5 gigabits per second. In one of my recent videos, I built a Pi 5 NAS and tested the transfer speeds using both an external USB and an SSD through the PCIe connector. The only thing limiting the speeds on the Pi was its own 1 gigabit per second network and network speeds here in my house. So let's make some changes and see how the Pi 5 performs with 2.5 gigabit networking. I'll also show you which parts of my home network was upgraded to get my main PC talking to the Pi 5 through 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. And of course, I'll be showing you speed test results on a pretty chart. Upgrading the Pi 5 to 2.5 gigabit networking is easier and cheaper than you might think. I purchased this ASUS USB 3.0 network dongle for $30 on Amazon. It looks like most of these adapters for reputable brands are being sold around $25 to $30 on Amazon. I chose this one because it has USB-A plug, and that's what I need for the Pi. According to Raspberry Pi, the Pi 5 has a total USB 3.0 throughput of 5 gigabits per second. So in theory, it should be able to handle the data coming through the 2.5 gigabit networking just fine. There are some other options for upgrading the Pi 5 to 2.5 gigabits, like this PCIe adapter from Pineberry Pi, which is now called Pineboards. But this adapter is $20 more expensive than just the USB dongle. It does look nice though. The USB dongle is 100% plug and play. It was recognized by Raspberry Pi OS as a new network interface right away. I plugged in the cable and I could see the network icon change to double arrows. The network on the Pi 5 wasn't the only thing that I had to upgrade though. All of the network switches around my house are 1 gigabit. So I also had to upgrade part of my network to make sure the communication between my main PC and the Pi 5 wasn't being limited by the 1 gigabit network. I did some searching and I went with this Moker Link 8-port 2.5 gigabit switch, and it cost me less than $90 on Amazon. I'll put some links down below. It's nice to see the price of 2.5 gigabit switches go down. This is actually a managed switch, and something like this a year ago would have cost me more than double what I just paid now. I also had to buy a 2.5 gigabit network card for my main PC. I went with this Brostrand adapter and was the cheapest part of the upgrade. I bought it for only $23 on Amazon. I had to get a second USB adapter so I could use it on my laptop for my living room. So I had one USB adapter on the Pi and one on my laptop. I'm only planning on using this dongle on my laptop when I'm editing videos or transferring a lot of data, so I don't have to be tethered to the wall when using my laptop. So all in all, I spent $170 to make part of my network 2.5 times faster than it used to be. That's not bad. And I still have enough ports on my new switch for other devices in the future. For instance, I have showed you this ROC 5B in previous videos, and it has 2.5 gigabit network built in. So I'll be able to take full advantage of its networking capabilities now with this new switch. And of course, I'll be comparing the speeds of the Pi 5 to the ROC 5B in this video. I have a router and other switches as part of my home network, so I had to make sure that my main PC, the laptop, and the Raspberry Pi 5 were connected through the same 2.5 gigabit switch. If any of the traffic had to be routed through one of the old 1 gigabit switches, well, it would be limited to 1 gigabit still. I had to make sure that everything's connected to the Moker Link. So alright, back to the Pi 5. I've been running this Pi as a NAS for a few months now, and it has been working great to share files across devices on my network. So my main motivation to get faster transfer speeds on this Pi 5 was because I want to store the files for video projects that I'm working on it. I personally use Davinci Resolve to edit my videos, and a nice thing about Resolve is that it allows you to store your video projects on a server. So you don't have to keep exporting the project files from one computer and importing into another computer if you want to work on the same project. I wanted to be able to edit my videos from either my favorite chair in my living room or from my desktop computer in the cat's room, my office. This Raspberry Pi 5 is also running as a Davinci Resolve project server. I have a blog post link below on how to set up the Pi 5 as a DaVinci Resolve server, so check it out. But to get the best experience editing videos directly from the network, I needed better transfer speeds than the old 1 gigabit. Or did I? I think the results I got are kind of surprising. At least it wasn't what I was expecting to be, so maybe a lot of you guys already know about this, but anyway, we'll get to it later in the video. So let's talk about transfer speeds. After I plugged into the Pi into the new switch, I got the orange link LED on the switch, meaning the connection was being negotiated at 2.5 gigabits per second. Very good. My first test was to make sure the Pi was able to use the full bandwidth, and it was. IPERF3 was reporting 2.3 gigabits per second. This was the communication between the Pi 5 and the ROC 5B, which, like I mentioned, has native 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Just as a side note, Pineboards has these really cool command boards where you can plug in more than one PCIe adapter to the Pi 5. But it gets kind of expensive when you start stacking up boards on the Pi 5. Pineboards was kind enough to send me some of their boards, but I bought everything else that you see in this video with my own money. Anyway, let's move on and take a look at some charts. Everyone is here for charts, right? In my previous video, I was getting around 850 to 900 megabits per second download and upload speeds when I was using the built-in 1 gigabit Ethernet on the Pi 5. But now, with my upgraded network, I'm getting much faster speeds with downloads staying consistent at 2.2 gigabits. It doesn't really dip that much during read operations. Uploads stay close to 2 gigabits, but it does dip lower at certain points. It's still a good average though, I'm pretty happy with it. So writing to the Pi 5 is not as fast, but it's still plenty fast. I'm mostly concerned with read speed since I'll be using this to edit videos directly from the NAS, so I'll be reading a lot more than writing. You might be asking yourself, can I get these speeds with the Pi 4 and 2.5 gigabit USB adapter? Well, more or less. Although you can get 2.5 gigabit link using the USB adapter, you can't really use the full speed over the 2.5 gigabit Ethernet adapter. I was getting 1.5 gigabits per second for both upload and download speeds. This is 50% faster than the built-in 1 gigabit connection that I had, but definitely not taking advantage of the full speed of the new 2.5 gigabit network that I have here in my house now. The Pi 5 has a much faster interface. Now, what about the speeds compared to the ROC 5B? The results were pretty close to what I was expecting to see. The read speeds are consistent at 2.2 to 2.3 gigabits per second, which is a tiny little bit better than the Pi 5 read speeds. The write speeds are a touch slower though, sometimes dipping under 1.5 gigabits per second. And although it was able to reach 2 gigabits, it was never able to settle at that speed and keep going. So for a read-heavy usage scenario like my scenario reading files from the NAS, the ROC 5B works perfectly fine. Interestingly though, the ROC 5B with 8 gigs of RAM retails for about $150. You can currently buy it for $100. This is a pretty good deal in my books, because it comes with built-in 2.5 gigabit networking and an onboard M.2 connector. No need for adapters. The Pi 5 with also 8 gigs of RAM retails for around $80. The 2.5 USB adapter is another $25, and you need a PCIe hat for the M.2 connector, which is yet another $20 if you account for the hats that take the 2280 size drives. This brings us to a total of $125 for the Pi 5. And of course, the total price for a setup like this one would be a little bit higher since you have to account for a power supply, SD card for the OS, I'm using OMV in this case, and the NVMe drive to store your data. But does faster network speeds really make a difference for video editing? It's complicated. Okay, so first of all, I record my videos in 1080p at 30 frames per second, meaning I'm not dealing with the huge file sizes that other creators might be dealing with. Like if you're shooting 4K videos or higher frame rates, you have much bigger file size than me. Video editing is a lot more about your computer's ability to decode video formats and the software that you are using than just network read speeds. Looking at network traffic when using Resolve open on my computer, it doesn't seem like it downloads a lot of data at once. There are these little spikes when I scrub through a clip or change to another clip, but nothing major, no major traffic in the network. This means that network speeds are probably not as important as a lot of people think it is for video editing. I've even done some editing over Wi-Fi, and I notice it is a tad slower when hardwired into the wall and getting the 2.5 gigabit networking. It's not that bad. It's totally doable. Okay, so a little bit of an editor's note here. Loading the project when I first open it is way faster on 2.5 gigabit. So I don't have anything open right now. I'm going to open this project from the NAS. And you can see the loading, the clip information, like down here, loaded right away, super fast. When I'm working on 1 gigabit or over Wi-Fi, of course, it takes much longer. All right, that's it. But faster transfer speeds are never a bad thing, especially only having to invest around $170 for this upgrade. I think it is worthwhile. I've talked about a mini PC build I've been working on and I'll be using it as a backup server. So it will be nice for it to take advantage of this new upgraded network speed. And by the way, if you have made it this far in the video, just thank you. I really appreciate it. And this is Pumpkin, my cat. She's the boss around here. If you're going to leave a comment, please mention, "Aw, Pumpkin," so I know you're one of the people that watched the video until the end. This video was just a little bit of an exploration with 2.5 gigabit networking on the Pi 5 and how editing videos directly from a NAS might not be as bad as some people think it is. I don't really think you need like 10 gigabit networking or 2.5 gigabit networking. So thanks for watching and see you in the next one.